Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my channel Leela Web Dev. I am happy to announce that we are starting a new course that is nothing but the Git. So what is this Git? So we will have a complete course regarding the Git and we will learn about the Git commands, what are the Git commands available and everything related to the Git thing. So here if you are able to see the introduction screen, that is if you are able to see that Git distributed version control system. So it is a distributed version control system. So what is this version control system actually? So then afterwards we can learn about this distributed thing. So the term distributed thing, we can learn it afterwards. But first what we need to know is, we need to know about this version control system. So shortly we will be calling this one as a VCS. Okay, so you will be able to see somewhere in the courses for me, in these videos, you will be able to see that VCS as a short form. That VCS is nothing but the version control system. So let's go one by one. So if you try to see here, Git is a version control system. Okay, so Git is a version control system. We will learn about this version control system afterwards, and also known as the VCS. Okay, in the website. So if you try to open any website, Git website or in Wikipedia, anywhere if you try to see, it will be written as a distributed version control system. So one new term is added before the version control system, that is nothing but the distributed version control system. So that means Git has a special advantages over the version control system, that is nothing but the distributed thing. So what is this distributed thing? We will try to learn it in the upcoming things. Now let's try to see. So now you need to know that Git is a version control system. Okay, now this Git software, who developed this one? So normally the Git software is developed by the Linus Torvalds. So this is the guy who has developed the Linux. He created the Git for the development of the Linux kernel. So why he has developed the Git is, he has developed the Git for the develop, when he is developing the Linux kernel. So that is the core of this Linux thing. So when he is developing this Linux kernel, he has created the Git. Why he has created the Git is, the Linux kernel is a set of code. So it is a software. So it is maintained by the multiple developers. Not only the Linus Torvalds will be writing the code, so many developers will be writing this code of for the Linux kernel. So for that reason, for the contribution, so in order to have the contribution for all the code for this Linux kernel, he has developed a feature that is known as the Git. Okay, now let's try to see the another one. Basically, what is this VCS actually? So now we know about this Git. Git is a version control system, and who developed the Git also we have known. So now we have able to know that Git is a version control system. So then what is this version control system? Basically, VCS is a software designed to record changes made to the file over time. So that means VCS is nothing but it's a software thing. It is designed to record the changes to the file. So that means whenever you are changing the file, you are changing from the file. Today you have changed some concept, some data in the file, and tomorrow you have changed some data in the file. So going on changing the data over that period of time, so in order to record those changes, so if you want to go to the particular period of time and you want to check the file, what is the data present at that time, so if you want to know, so this VCS is the software which is able to record the changes. So it will record the changes daily, it will record the changes of this file over the time when it is got changed. So it will record the changes, so that if you want to know the data of the file for a particular period of time, means you can be able to know using this software. So that means Git gives us the ability to revert the files or the set of files you made changes. So that means when you have made the changes to a file over a period of time, and if you want to go to that period of time and you want to get the data back from that time, means you can able to get the data for that particular file using the Git. So this is the main usage of the Git. So the main usage of the Git is nothing but the file, whatever the file it may be. Over a period of time, it is going on changing the file, means we will be able to get the data back from that period of time. So that is the main thing. So now let's go. Git not only records the source code. Okay, so you need to remember this one. So some people will be able to thinking that some developers means Git will only record the source code. Source code means nothing but the code which is written, the Java code or PHP or JavaScript, whatever the source code you'll be able to, the languages programming code, right? So people will be thinking that this Git is only used for this programming languages thing only. So it will be recording those programming languages code only. They will be thinking. So misconception is there on the Git. But it also tracks the images, research papers, or any types of files. So if you are having a type of research papers or anything, if you are having some data files or anything, so Git tracks all the types of files. So not only the source code, it can track all the types of files. So that is the main advantage of the Git. Now, actually, we have three kinds of version control system in our computer field. So we will be maintaining the three kinds of version control system. Now you will be able to understand. First one is the local version control system. Second one is the centralized version control system. And third one is the distributed version control system. Now these are the three types of version control systems available in our day-to-day life. So first, what is this local version control system? Let's try to see. Local version control system is, long days back, many people use this method. Even me also using this method. So everyone will be able to understand this method. It is very simple. This method is to copy files into another directory. For example, see, today you have some abc.txt file, x.txt file. You have one x.txt file. You have changed some data in that file. So you have changed some data and all those things. Before changing the data, what you will try to do? You will keep a backup in another directory with that name, something like x_backup. If you are more clever, means what you will try to do, x_backup_today's date you will try to keep, something like April 4th, 2021. So that means that x.txt file backup is the data which is present at the time, 4th April 2021 of the time. So you will try to maintain the backup. For example, tomorrow you came and before continuing working, what you will try to do, you will try to keep a backup of that one, x_backup_5th April. Like this, you will try to keep the, what you will say, backup of the file. So you will go on keeping the backup of the file every day. So day to day, daily, depending on your period. So depending on your changing fluctuality, so you will be maintaining the data. So now this method is to copy files into another directory. They keep the files with the timestamp directory. Timestamp directory is nothing but the, what we can say, that timestamp. So how that today's date, how you are keeping. And it is also very simple that we maintain the backup. It is very simple. So maintaining that one is very simple. So nothing to do. So what you will try to do, whatever the file you are having, completely you will copy that one and you will place it in the backup directory. So that whenever you want, something happens to the data present you are working with, instead of doing control Z everything, you will directly take the backup data, so recent backup data, and you will paste it there so that you will have the recent backup. So this is the local version control system. So now you will be able to understand that using this local version control system, you will be having lots of folders. You will be having, sometimes you will be having a problem that you will copy one file over the other file, so that the previous backup data will be missed. And sometimes you will be having that the data may be corrupted or data may be deleted. These are all the problems you will be having. So this is the normal way how the layman users or something like that, we will be maintaining the backup of the file. So the changes, whatever the changes we are making in the day-to-day life, in order to keep that one backup, you will be using this type of version. So everybody knows about this way of keeping the backup structure. Now let's come to the centralized version control system. So what is this centralized version control system? Now, in order to collaborate with other developers, so the backup what we have maintained in the local version system, it is applicable to only one developer. Now, if multiple developers are working in within one file, means now this centralized version control system is used. So if in x.txt file, if multiple developers are working on this one, means we will be using the centralized version control system. This system have a single server. Okay. So now this system will have a single server. So somewhere you will be having a single server. And that one will have all the files. So that one will be having all the version files, and number of clients can take the files from that central place. So whenever you want to take the file, means you will take the file from that central version file, central server, and with that central server, you will take the latest version of that file so that you can work on this one. So for many years, this is the standard for version control. So this is the standard of version control. So for many years, we will be using this centralized version control system only. So now what I can say, the examples are CVS, subversion and perforce are the examples of this method. Now how it will be, we will see it in a graphical representation. So here you are having a computer A and computer B, two developers are there. So they are working on the same file. And now what they will try to do is, they will have one centralized server. In that server, you will be having a file and it will be having the versions of that file. So you will take the latest version of that file, and computer B also takes the latest version of the file. So that two developers will have the same code you'll be having. And also, whenever you want to push it, you can push it to the centralized server, so that computer B also takes that modified data. So this is the central server, is the main hub. So instead of maintaining in a local version in your own computer, you will be depending on the centralized server, centralized computer, where every clients will be connected to that server to take the updated data. Okay, so now advantages of this centralized VCS. So this has what more advantages over the local VCS. Now we will be able to know that local VCS is nothing but the keeping of the backup of the each backup of the every folder, you will be keeping the backup, right? So this has advantages. Centralized VCS has advantages over the local VCS. Everyone can know what is going on in the project. Yes, everyone can know. So why? Because the project is hosted in the centralized server. Everyone can take the data from that server and they can check that what is going on the project. And administrators who are maintaining the server can have the control that who can do what. So who are doing what, and the administrators can have a full control over the centralized VCS. Everyone can get the project update immediately, as all are linked to the one centralized server. So that means everyone can get the project update immediately. The files update or the project update, they will get immediately as all are linked to one centralized server. So these are the advantages. Then what will be the disadvantages of this one? If the centralized server goes down for an hour. So now if the centralized server is there, means so it is connected through one source. That is nothing but the internet. So if the internet goes down, so the centralized servers goes down for an hour, means nobody can collaborate at all. So that means all the developers cannot collaborate. So they cannot get the update and what they cannot get anything. So or save the changes to the centralized server. So they cannot save, they cannot say, they cannot push their changes to the, they cannot send their changes to the centralized server, and nobody can get the update from the centralized server. And if the hard disk of the centralized database is on, becomes corrupted. So now the hard disk in which the central database is corrupted and proper backup haven't been kept, you lost absolutely everything. So this is also one problem. If the hard disk is corrupted in the centralized VCS server, means so if you are not maintained any proper backup, means everything is lost, everything. Local VCS suffer from the same problem. So why? Because now you will be having in your own system, right? Local VCS, when it is corrupted, means you will be having the same problem. Whenever you have the entire history of the project in a single place, you risk loss everything. So this is the main thing. So whenever you are having the entire history of the project, enter changes or anything, records of the project in a single place, so you will be having a risk of losing everything. So this is the main disadvantage. Now for overcoming this one, we got the distributed version control system. So what is this distributed version control system? Clients not only check out the snapshot of the file. So that means here in the centralized version system, so what they will be trying to get, they are trying to get the latest snapshot. That means latest version of the file only they will be able to get. They will not able to get all the versions. They can at a time get only one version of the file. Okay, so now either he can check the version 3, or either he can check the version 2, or either he can check the version 5, version 1, like that. So now in the distributed, clients not only check the snap, they can also fully mirror the repository, including its full history. So that means they can fully get the repository. Repository is nothing but the project. Okay, you take it as a project. So now here we will be calling the distributed version control, we will call it as a repository. So you can fully mirror the repository, including its full history. So that means including its all versions and all those things, you will get everything to the client. So in client system, that means in the computer, you can also maintain the versions So now in the client system, so you can maintain the versions of the file, so that when the server is up, you can fully copy back it to the server. So now it doesn't depend on the server now. So if the server is down also, you can maintain the versions in your client local, so that when the server is up, you can copy the entire thing into the server. So every clone means nothing but every backup, every code the computer, the clients will be taking, is a full backup of all the data. Instead of taking single snapshot like centralized VCS, distributed version control gives you the full backup of the data. Now how could be here, if you try to see the server control, server computer will be having the versions like this, same like the centralized database. Now the computer A file, you will be having again the versions for you, and here the computer B, again he has the same versions for his file. So now he can maintain the versions here, and he can maintain the versions here. The versions also came copied back here, see. Now you can push it to the server and you can interact with the server like this. So now in your local computer also, you can maintain the versions And in the server also, you can maintain the versions. So now when the server is down also, you will be having the versions of the same versions in your local computer also, so that you can move back and you can check back your everything. So this is the what is the distributed version control system. So now Git is the distributed version control system. You will be having something like Git, Mercurial. These all things are the distributed version control system. So now this is the introduction of the what we can say Git distributed version control system. In the next video, we will move further about the Git thing. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, please do support me by subscribing to my channel. Thank you.